Welcome everyone here to the King's Table. I'm your host, Truck, Big Truck, coming from a place somewhere out there in the universe. I know I took a little break, but I'm back. Had to refine some things. Like I said, starting this platform here, it does take a while, but I'm learning more and more and more. I'm growing. And I'm so thankful and grateful for your cooperation, each and every king and queen out there. Remember, log on to my YouTube, Truck Nation Presents. Hit the subscribe button. Increase the likes. Hit those likes. I pray and hope that each and every video that I have so far that you do like, and that it does something to you, touches you in some type of way. But today, I want to shift things a little bit and talk about something that came across my way. Checking my emails and everything, doing my daily search, you know, on my platforms and everything. There's certain things that come across to me, and it was this one thing here that I like to address or share. It's the top 10 traits. It's from Forbes. The top 10 traits men look for in a wife. And I prayed on that for a little bit, because my thing is, yes, I do want to address men. Yes, my channel, my platform is to share with men about male growth, but also women can tune in too. You got to be careful of who you listen to. You have to be careful who you take advice from, because not everybody has the best advice. Not everybody understands your situation. So going back to this email I received from Forbes, you can look it up as well. Top 10 traits that men look for in a wife. Here it is. One of the things that stood out to me, number 10, ambition. You gotta be ambitious. And I believe that this can also go both ways, to be honest with you. Because there are traits, there are things that women look for in a husband or in a man, and vice versa. A man look for in a woman when you're talking about a wife. Okay? You got to be ambitious. You got to have goals. You got to know what you want and who you are, and set those principles. You got to be willing to set boundaries. Marriage, you're going to have storms, but it's a team effort thing. It's not about, I want a six-figure man or I want a six-figure woman. Because at the end of the day, does those individuals want you? It should be about love. It should be about peace. It should be about, hey, look, we're going to rock this thing until the end. To me, a large number of people disrespect the word marriage. They haven't taken the time to fully understand what it means. Okay? If you looked at my videos, Run Till That Part 1 and Part 2, I basically shared my past experiences of what I went through. But again, there's a difference between I love you and I'm in love with you. I'm in love with you means I'm going to rock with you. We're going to rock together. I'm going to stand by you. I'm going to stand with you. Regardless of the naysayers, we're going to ride this thing. Versus, I love you, but if things don't work in my favor, don't work the way that I want them to, I'm out. Let's go to number 9. Desire for home and children. I kind of like that. when I say desire for the home and children, are you a family person? Many people go in, a large number of individuals go into marriage for the wrong reasons. I love the person, but not the children. And we've all either we experienced it or we've seen it. And we know that that doesn't end too well. Because if you're going into a marriage, especially for us men, that they go into a relationship with women that have children, love goes all the way around. Love gets spread to the woman and children. Love gets spread to everybody. You can't just love the woman and not the children. You knew what you were getting yourself into before you entered the marriage. You got to fulfill that. Now, from a woman's perspective, I'm not a woman, but I would feel that the same applies. If a woman goes into a relationship or a marriage with the man that has children. Good looks, number 8. We all want to be with someone that we're all sexually attracted to. I believe it's not about this perfect person. Oh, I want all this dime piece. But also, you want to have judgment of character with the person that you are selecting. Know who you are selecting. Number 7, good health. You gotta have good health, be healthy. Taking care of your health, meaning not only just eating right, but exercising. We all wanna be with someone that we are sexually attracted to. Emotionally, spiritually, mentally, all of those things to me kind of plays a part. Number 6, sociability. You got to be able to socialize with others. You have to be, if I take my significant other out and we're going to a family outing, is she going to socialize with the family or my friends? Can she communicate? Number 5, pleasing disposition. And I want to read this. Men place a potential wife's pleasing disposition at number 5. Have included it in their top 5. In the 1930s, on the other hand, women in recent years are less likely to prioritize a man's pleasing disposition. Until recently, women consistently rank in at number 4, but it currently appears as number 7. When we're talking about pleasing disposition, where are you at? Can you bring love and peace into a marriage? What do you have to bring other than the physical into a marriage? Number 4, education and intelligence. Look around you. Can we have an intelligent conversation? Can we talk about things that are worth talking about? Can we learn from each other? Education. Can we educate each other? What kind of knowledge do we have that we can share between each other? These are the things that we're talking about men looking for in a wife. But you can also flip it. Wives look for in a husband. You got to be willing to and able to have intelligent conversations. Integrity is good. Honesty is good. Respect is good. Handling your handle is good. Handling your man duties or your woman duties. Whatever it takes to build that happy marriage, to build that good marriage, it does take teamwork. Everyone has to do their part. Number 3, emotional stability and maturity. Emotional stability. If I'm going through something, I need to count on my wife to be there. Or vice versa. Can I count on you to be there? Can I count on you to keep me encouraged, keep my spirits lifted? If I get fired and lose my job, in the process of looking for work, can I count on you to be there? Encourage me, not tear me down and belittle me. Number two, dependable. Character. What is your character like? What is your character like? Who are you? What are you? Is your character in its right place? Number one, mutual attraction and love. Those are the things I want to look for. That. I need that. I want that. But again, this was something that came across. I just wanted to address it and share it. What do you think, kings and queens? When we're talking about what we're looking for or what we need, are we willing, are we really addressing that? Are we communicating that? Because here's the thing, closed mouths don't get fed. And when it comes to your life, when it comes to your future, not only knowing who you are, but you got to be prepared for it. Marriage is a long road. Marriage can be fun if you allow it to be. You determine. You have to know your worth. And I know this is a little bit shifting, but again, like I told you, on this platform, we're going to talk about many things. My thing is, whatever I can say to uplift, but open the eyes, and of course, being open-minded. We have to be open-minded when we come into a lot of things. We can't be afraid to make a mistake. Hey, it's okay. I made a mistake. Now I know I'm going to do better. I gave many examples. One of the things I love about giving examples is it gives an individual an opportunity to really break things down and come from a perspective. Of course, here at the King's Table, we are open-minded. We have to be open-minded. It's not about taking shots. I never want to take shots at someone or degrade someone, but I'm going to uplift you. I'm going to tell you where you're right at and where you're wrong at. Yeah, sometimes it seems like I'm going in different places, but I guarantee you, them different places that I go in, it's always food for thought, food for the soul. My thing is letting your soul speak. And as I continue to build this platform, I'm looking at having more guests come on the show. I'm looking at channeling into other areas and other people, because I want to hear it from you. I want to hear from the men. I want to hear from the women. I want to hear from the broken men. I want to hear from the men that's going through hell and back and then some. I want to hear from the women that have gone through hell and back. In order to have a clear understanding, yes, you have to be open-minded. Yes, when it comes to marriage, it's a team effort thing. When it comes to relationship, it's a team effort thing. We both have to do our parts. No one is better than the other. Men, we need you. We need you, women. We need our queens, and vice versa. But it takes a real person to step up and say that. And say, you know what? I know I need a queen in my life. But I'm positioning myself. Because in order to have that, I gotta be ready. I gotta be prepared. What is it that I need to do as a man? And now I'm seeing the things that I need to do as a man so that when she does walk into my life, okay, we're gonna have some pitfalls here and there. But first, we're gonna pray about it. Second, we're gonna work it out. And third, we're gonna let it go. One thing I cannot stand is when people bring up stuff from the past to throw darts at someone. That's not how you do things. And have the right intent when you are dealing with your mate. Storm's gonna come. Oh, yes. Marriage, it takes work. It really does. Those know what I've been through. I overcame it. And if I can help someone else, and I'm being led to help someone else, in the mighty name of Yahweh Shai, I'm going to do it. Because I'm led to. I'm led to say something. I pray for all. Every beautiful soul that's watching live, that's watching this broadcast, I pray that Elohim does great works in your life, that he opened up doors in your life, that he leads you where you need to be led, that he touches your heart, pierces your soul, that great things happen to you. Unexpected doors open. When you look back, of course you give him the honor, the glory, and the praise. But you can also help someone else. Because you don't ever know what someone else is going through until you share your story. And it helps them. It blesses them. It touches them in a way. Like I said, I was just checking my emails and I received that from Forbes.com. What men look for in a wife. The 10 traits that men look for in a wife. I said, wow, this may be something to share at the King's table. Because here we talk about it. We bring it to the table. We discuss it. We speak truth and we speak life. We don't lie to people. We don't mislead people. But we spread love. Because men, it's hard being a man every day. Especially if you're a father, husband, it's hard. The things that we deal with day to day to day to day. Sometimes we just want to just break down and give up, but we can't because there's a fight in us. There's something in us that says, I need to move forward. There's something better. There's something greater. Abba Father, give me the strength to press through. Give me the strength that I need because I need it. And when you have something good, kings keep it. When you have something good, queens keep it. Good people are not made like they're used to. You see the generation that we're living in. It behooves me how good men and women are getting passed up. But soon as those that get hurt, they get used, have the audacity to say, look what happened to me. Look who you chose versus who you let go, who you let walk out of your life. Elohim gave you a blessing. You threw the blessing right back in his face. And you wonder why you're going through what you're going through. Take responsibility. And that goes both ways, to men and women. Man shouldn't have to pay for everything. We're going to split this thing in half. Because it's a team thing. And if you ain't about teamwork, let me know how that works for you. Because I guarantee you, You're gonna regret it. Until then, to all my beautiful kings and queens out there, here at the King's Table, I love you. Go out there and be the best version of yourself. Talk to you later. Shalom.